Welcome to the coop. Welcome to the Southern Coop of 7, almost 8. Come up with a new name. Not sure on that yet. But anyway, so for now, we're still the coop of 7, the Southern Coop of 7. And I haven't done a pregnancy update in a while, so I thought I would take down some notes and share with you what's been going on. I think it's been about 3 weeks, I think. I'll share with you how things are going and, well, what's been going on, period. So, I had my 25-week checkup today. So, technically, I'm 25 weeks today. And it was a really quick appointment when I got there. I had the urine check and my weight, my blood pressure check, all that good stuff with the nurse. She came in, she did the heartbeat. And then we ended up waiting, seemed like forever, but it really wasn't that long. Probably like 20 minutes before the doctor came in, because he had been down at the hospital on surgery, so he couldn't come in for a while. And little mommy came in with me, and we brought her some of her schoolwork to work on. So bless her heart. But boy, did we ever get that vocabulary in. So when he came in, he seemed kind of like he was rushing a little bit, and I really didn't get to say all that I wanted to say, but usually I do that anyway. My words get all bleh, and I just can't get my words out. So, anyway, from what he said, everything seems to be going normal, and we are just moving right along as we should be. So, yeah. So I'll jump into the facts. I have now, as of today, gained already 20 pounds. That disturbs me a little, because my ultimate goal weight for the pregnancy is 30 pounds. And I feel like once I get into the third trimester, usually I have no control over it, and baby just grows like crazy, no matter whether I eat little, because I usually don't eat a lot in the third trimester. I don't have room to eat. So where is it going? I have no idea. My husband is so sweet to me, because I keep saying it. I just feel huge already, and he keeps saying, you don't look huge, you only have 15 weeks left, you don't look that big at all. So he's been very encouraging to me whenever I have been kind of in a slump about it. I appreciate that so much, because it bothers me to be feeling like this. And I just try to keep remembering my joy. I was going to show you, I've got my joy oil close by. Remember, my joy of this whole purpose is I'm growing a human, okay? I have been gifted to do this, so I need to just chill out and remember when this sweet baby is out, we'll worry about the weight. For now, I've got to just feed myself nutritiously and exercise and take care of myself the best that I can. So that's what we're working on. But I was a little bothered by my weight. But that gives me, it's been a month since I've been there for my appointment. So as of today, I gained 5 pounds from my last appointment. My biggest complaint, and I don't even like to complain. I think I've said that before. I don't like to complain because I feel so blessed to be in the position that I'm in and so honored. But I am exhausted, so tired all the time. This morning, I'm trying my best to get up before everybody. We have been going constantly doing something, and I know that probably exercise wise and I feel like that is really healthy for me and for the children and our family, of doing things and staying active versus just sitting at home and being a lump. So I don't want to use those, and I'm gonna call it our adventures, as an excuse of why I'm exhausted. But I just think my body is physically tired. At the end of the day, I am ready to go to bed before the kids are ready to go to bed, and that's not good. Keep striving and pushing forward. And I know I'm not the only one in that ballgame, because I was tired beforehand, but now I'm really tired, it seems like. And I just have to keep going and persevere through that little time. And typically, whenever our two youngest take afternoon naps, I try to nap with them to at least rest for 20 minutes and let my body just chill out, rest, and try to kind of revive up some energy to keep going. But we have been so busy that nap times have been non-existent or they've been in the car. And I don't sleep in the car. They do, I don't. And when I went to the doctor today, my biggest concern, I have been having lots and lots of pressure. And I usually do this, that's not unusual, toward the end of my third trimester. That's pretty common. I remember it very well with especially my last two, but not this early on. So I'm 25 weeks and I am already feeling major Braxton Hicks, but no pain. So that's okay. But I do feel lots of pressure pushing down on me. And I know the baby can't just like whoop slide out, but seeing as this is our sixth baby, what are the chances of my cervix already starting to open up because I feel so much pressure? I don't know. But I feel like the baby has had a growth spurt, so to speak, because I have been so tired. But again, I don't know if that's because the baby is growing or because we have just been going and doing so much. We took a big trip last weekend, and then like we come home and there's all the laundry to do, and it's, you know, just back to normal everyday life, and it's just nonstop. There's something going on all the time. And we're also getting ready to go on another trip. Yeah, I don't know where's the cutoff on what could be like physically going on or what could just be, it's just typical pregnancy symptoms. So I don't know. I can't figure it out. But this afternoon we did get a good 40 minute rest time in, and I really felt like my body needed that because I always get kind of nervous on doctor days anyway, because you know, it's just nerve-wracking going to the doctor and checking your blood pressure and checking your weight and making sure you get the baby's heartbeat, all of that, just like it kind of stresses me out a little bit, to be honest with you. And I just need to get rid of some of my anxiousness and we'll be okay. But like I said, low pressure, lots of low pressure. Don't know. My doctor did not seem to be concerned at all. He said, especially with this being our sixth baby, that I'm going to feel that pressure probably a little stronger and a little bit more frequently than I would if it were my first baby. So I'm going to go with that. I have noticed, especially with all of our traveling, although my husband will hardly let me do anything, so it's not like I'm doing a whole lot. As far as lifting and such, I'm always like, I can do this. Okay, I'm not helpless. I can do this. I promise I can help. Friend pressure and low back pain, all typical pregnancy symptoms, I know, but they still, they're there. Bag that I microwave for like 2 minutes and I put that on my lower back area. I don't like to do that for a long period of time because I'm afraid of it harming the baby. So, and other than that, everything is going really, really well. Like I have no like terrible, horrible complaints. This pregnancy, I will say, has probably been the easiest thus far. So I like to keep it that way. Just kind of be aware of like if pain comes on, then I probably need to do something about that. All right, so we have expanded, and I'm gonna show you the baby. But I feel like we have expanded a lot. I really feel like the baby has had a huge growth spurt, and my clothes, which I had bought for this pregnancy because I didn't have a lot of maternity clothes anymore, I got rid of all them. My blue jeans are so tight, like so tight. They're miserably fitting on me, especially when we went on a trip. I felt like cutting into me, and I couldn't stand it. So I was ready to get into some pajama pants. I did invest in a pair of maternity overalls. I love them. They're so comfortable. But I was gonna share, in case any of you are either expecting or planning to be expecting, Walmart. No joke, Walmart. I bought 3 pair of like these jeggings. I got a black pair, a blue jean pair, and I got a gray cotton pair. So they're not really jeggings, they're more like leggings. But they are so soft and they're so comfortable. I got them up a size, seeing as how I still have a pretty far ways to go. I went ahead and upped a size, and I've worn them, but I have to wear something really low because they're so baggy right here to cover this part of me up. But they are really comfortable and they're very affordable. I think for the cotton ones, they were like $6 and some change. Can't remember exactly. And then the jean ones were like maybe 11. So that was affordable for me. Like I said, I got 3 pair and I'm hoping to live in those the next 15 weeks. I also went to a consignment sale and I picked up a pair of longer blue jean shorts because all the maternity shorts that I have seen are like way up here and I can't do that. I should be good now unless the baby even grows past those. And if that's the case, then yeah, I'm in trouble. I don't want to get bigger than that. All right, so we have now officially bought baby some stuff because I'm thinking, okay, we've had 5 babies now and each baby we found out what the gender is before, so we knew exactly what to buy. But this baby, well, we don't know what the gender is, so we're gonna be surprised. And I don't know what to buy the baby. Probably have enough to get by for a little while anyway. And then I said I'm just gonna get some white onesies. We've already bought a very large pack of size 1 swaddler diapers for the baby. And so I guess that's everything baby-wise up to date. And I'm still very excited about not knowing whether it's a boy or girl. I have really led more to a boy until, like, yesterday I almost ate an entire bowl of fruit from Publix, like, you know, the big fruit bowls that you can get. And I've only done the fruit cravings with my girls. So I was like, maybe it is a girl. But the heart rate today was 140. And I think that's the lowest of all of my babies. I don't think any of them have been that. As a matter of fact, when they said 140, I was like, oh, is that okay? Because that's really low. Usually it's like 150, 160, and my girls were always around like the 170-ish. So initially, this baby started at around 160, 170. I think the last visit was 150. I have no idea. It's just, But I am carrying really low. A teacher friend of mine yesterday from our homeschool co-op said she carried one of her girls low. So I can't really go off of if it's a girl, it would be higher. Because I don't know. I have no idea. So in the comments, I would love to know, do you think we're having a boy? Or do you think we're having a girl? Either way, we're excited. There will be complete shock for either one, I think, because half of us think boy and half of us think girl. We don't know. It's fun to kind of just not know. But at the same time, a little part of me is like, I think it's a, Anyway, so I'm going to wrap this up. And if you are not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel. My goal is to do 2 vlogs a week. I don't know if I'm going to get that done or not. Camera-wise, we've shifted phones. We got a new iPad. And I told you I had some surprises coming in store. And I'm hoping to get a brand new camera. A really nice camera that I can use for vlogging. And that hasn't worked out yet. So keep that thought on hand. And hopefully our vlogs can improve with that. But it really takes a lot of time to edit. And yeah, just all that stuff. It takes time. So, there's other priorities that I have to put in front right now. This is just a hobby for me. I like to do this for fun. And I like hearing from friends and keeping kind of like a scrapbook online for us. It's fun. So if you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe to our channel and comment if you think we're having a boy or a girl. And I'm gonna end it with a photo so you can see how we are carrying. And we'll see you next time. So thanks for watching. Bye.